So everybody, it's Ma here. Welcome to Nerd Kitchen's versus battle. I hope you guys will be enjoying this one. It's going to be coming into the kitchen. Listen to this one, as you see by the title. This is going to be Kyle Crane from Dying Light 1, the great protagonist of the case of the zombie slaying game, the great parkour slayer, the great killer, the great proficient case mercenary that turned away from the case instance of just being the job to a full-time case of living, and no matter the case of what was the past, now is in the present of being something of a symbol of hope in the case instance of the people of Iran. First is Jason Brody, Snow White, the man that dominated two case of great killer groups in the case instance of Hoyt's Militia and the case of Oz Pirates. Hope you guys will enjoy. In case of this versus battle, it's going to be interesting. Let's go and get into it.
All the things you need, you still want problems though. All the things I know, I still been silent though. Yeah, used to be at Silver City Indigo. Used to be in lunchroom playing dominoes. I don't wanna have to go to funerals. I gotta start sleeping at the studio. I don't have no time to be no Romeo. All the love I need is at the rodeo. All the love I need is here at OVO. Yeah. All the girls I know are there with Ian Thoe. Who knows where I end up when that shit gets old. Maybe it never gets old and that's just how it goes. Last table left in carbone, call the place on a rotary phone. I take a glass of Domi Nah to go with me home. Might move our annual shit to the dome.
Kyle Crane of Dying Light is a very dope protagonist. I miss this character and I'm glad that I got to go and replay it with this being said. Kyle Crane was a mercenary working for the GRE, governmental something regard of defense and research, like formal shit. He was sent in to go ahead and look for a case of a file that was going to ensure something for the GRE in the same instance of finding something. In this case, with him, the OPS Tempest was going to be in the same instance of something that could insurance, I think, in the form of better quantity of research and the means for to go ahead and take down a virus or use it as a way to go ahead and sell to the highest bidder pretty much in an open buy market. And he was sent into the case of the city of Iran based off another sentence of Arabic sentence of city, sent in to the city where the case of Iran virus, aka the zombie virus that you guys obviously could take, went and exploded boomingly. In this case, to go look for Kudusuma, aka Rise, who now leaded his own case of mercenary like form of military regard of people. And this man came in the midst to go ahead and again get the information, go ahead and use the people around him to go ahead and bigger look into that and do some other stuff. But while doing it, with this being said, he went into a whole new case instance of adventure than he thought he would do. It was supposed to be a simple regarded job, and instead, within a case of landing over in Iran, my man met case of one of Rise's dudes, his fucking second in command, his fucking general like shit, and that dude with his goons jumped him. He popped one of them with his pistol, and then later on, this course of instance of him meeting Jade and another dude that was also a GRE agent and was sent in before someone like Crane, who I think possibly Crane was gonna push, possibly meet up with, know about, things like that. But in the case of being in the same sense of this situation that he's in now, needed to go ahead and fully commit to the same sense of the mission. But in the same sense of the mission, he also got in touch with a biter, as you see, that bit him. And when you get bit, obviously it means that you could turn, but the only way to go ahead and slow down and somewhat case instance dial back on the regard of turning is antizin, aka the case of the drug that pretty much slows down into subsequent gives a common reasonable case of cure to the person that had to deal with the case in the sense of a bite, and within getting bit and then correspond with his case of bite men and sentence of injury, causing the death of this dude that you see getting mauled, getting fucking eaten up to bits like fucking lamb chops. My man now had to be stuck in haram, depending on these people needing to go do bigger things in the same sense to get to where he was. And following the game, this no longer became just a job, became a sense of his life, helping other people, having compassion and sympathy for them and feeling them, and seeing that the GRE are cold-blooded monsters. So in the case of this full-fledged scumbags, he now believed proudly that this is the place where it needs to be, and that he would go and help these people. And going along the game, helping out the case of the people in the tower, becoming a runner, and then Sue helping out the case of Brecken, this Australian dude that was a parkour instructor and then taught these people how to survive and pushed them to the fullest, eventually meeting Rise, doing some stuff for him, eventually down ladders of seeing who Rise was, killing him, surviving the night within the case of the volatiles, virals, and all the cases of the matter of the zombie mutations, and then turning about in the case of the sense of helping these people in Sector Zero, becoming a hero, becoming the fastest nigga in Haran, becoming this great A killer of zombies and a dude you cannot be fucked with, and eventually killing Rise in a great spectacular case of outcome. Crane is a very good, hard dude at his grand scope, and only did this for whatever means of a job, to be fair. But then becoming this full case symbol and doing a lot of his stuff, but going through some hardship and a fortune sense of stuff, did do what he needed to do for not just himself but people, and then having the file, coping with getting the same sense of the research from the dude that voiced Achilles, aka the old man that fortunately had to get stabbed. Research, he would go on to the case of the other dot over in Sector Zero, putting him on game with the same sense of information, and then from then the case of matter of that, he would try to go and push an assurance of a cure. Fortunately, that did not go and happen. And later on, going within the case of the following, a bunch of other stuff, of course, into play. I got to talk about it a bit more, even though all that stuff that comes into play there as a bunch of an issue we're not going to get into, because, again, the fair regard stands in the consistency and the baseness, and I wouldn't want to go ahead and talk about that. But simply to talk about some of the story stand within the case of the character of Crane, he would go down to the matter of falling when the case of the doc, case of research, did not really puff out anything big, as he was helping him to ensure a possible sane sense of cure. But they were running out of answers and people were dying. Bunch of people could not go ahead and take this anymore, and it was just a whole dilemma. And so he went out of Haran after this one-eyed man spouting a bunch of stuff about people, even if they get bit, they don't turn, talking about the mother, talking about priestess, the faceless, all this stuff. So he went on Haram, and then in the midst of going out into the following, went and seek the case of the help, and after helping the locals, help the community understand the scenario, feeling out the place, this later on incurring the case of matter for the means of not having to deal with all the bullshit that came in ensuance from stuff like that, from the case of gaining help from them, but even in the case of the help and all the different prize that came with it, there was also a case of a con coming into it where he was seen as so useful that multiple times over there'll be new case matter shenanigans. And after taking out a dude named Khan that was trying to go ahead and play him and set him up, he would have to go ahead and go onto the base of matter of the mother to possibly get help, but then finding out that the mother was actually a sentient volatile, a case of these demon regard zombie infected, and then depending on your ending, you either go ahead and side with her within the purpose to go ahead and rid the disease that is the Haran virus and nuke it in the entire case of city in the outer scope of Haran, and pretty much damn near half of the country was blown to bits, or you can go ahead and fight against her and being your character, and you turn into a case of a sentient volatile, beat her, rip her head off. But because of the fact that you became a sentient volatile, you later on turned and you spread the rest of the virus on accident, which is how it leaks out to the rest of the world. Now, I don't know entirely Dying Light 2's case in the story after the case of matter for that, because obviously Crane is dead in both endings, regardless, either being killed, killing himself, or just eventually over time dying in the midst, because I don't know the sun, because you know volatiles can't survive in the case instance of the sun, without case instance of clothing, or say instance of later on coming in case of adaptability to it, like how the mother did, I think. But Haran would either be exploded, or later on, in the case of after Krang did what he did in the spreading, bring it out, because Krang went so out of the bounds of Haran that it would spread to that extent. And wherever Dying Light 2 takes place, which I know is not Haran, with the new protagonist, that would happen. Now, I don't care too much about that, because all accounts, Dying Light 2 is nasty, so I don't care. But that's pretty much Krang's story in the fullest. Besides that, though, we're going to talk about kind of feet scaling, whatever bigger stuff with that being said. And
Crane? Hello, Crane. Can you hear me? It's Camden.
Yeah, Doc. I hear you. What's going on?
The analysis just finished on the tissue samples. The results are, well, I don't think the word phenomenal is too strong. Crane? If you can recover Zara's data, I'm certain a cure is within reach.
All right. Hey, we'll talk about it next time I see you.
This is Ayo speaking. Get to the nearest safe house and wait until dawn. Good night, and good luck.
Crane is a very adamant character, as I've already showcased and talked about beforehand. When it comes down to Crane, his overarching capabilities, with this being said, is adamant, as Crane is a very fast individual, showcasing speed that I wouldn't say is supersonic, even though if you wanted to go and try to wank from him pulling off some male Faith Mirror's Edge shit, to the case of bullets, it's a mixed bar, but you can get multi-time tagged by bullets, even though he is very resistant and durable dude, taking these bullets and not getting multi-case blicky, what is being said, in the midst of getting shot with them. So I would say I'm very confident on the sense that he's not supersonic, but you could make arguments basically stacks to virals, volatiles, and other people that can dodge arrows, that he's at least the case of subsonic in the matter of speed, what is being said. So that's pretty consistent, that's pretty solid in the case of matter for the run of stuff to be said. But with his overarching sense, since the speed take is being said, comes all in the case instance for how he's been able to show great efficiency and persistent case of blitzing in the midst of combat to kill. As you've seen these one different conversations when he was about to be killed by Ryze's men, he multi-case shadow jutsu fucking Ryu ninja gate and speed blitz his way out of the confrontation. And he has done these type of things in multiple occasions when you really get to the form of speed blitzy form movement. As again, he's a very adamant fighter. He only fights zombies here and there most of the time, but he has fought human people and he has outdone them. He's killed men before, killed thousands of zombies. He did eventually kill Ryze and was able to swiftly move out of his way in different occasions, being said. And again, he's also just in general very efficient. When it comes down to the case instance of durability, mixed with tap potency with Newton's third law, as you see in these different form of clips, he's been able to take hits from demolishers who are able to crack cars, be able to throw them, slam into the ground, and take boulder-sized disc and throw them at the player, which if you get hit by, Crane takes damage, but he's able to get back from, and it doesn't do too much damage if you're at full health, with this being said. Again, he has also been hit by him, hit by volatiles, hit like trucks, been hit by high regard people, hit with some different regard of bombs and different explosions, and ability to survive them, putting him in the case from the wall level to wank to considerable consistent of the arguable low small building level tier within some of these different cases of explosions and different hits and taking these people to the bank when it comes down to fighting. It also is consistent where he's able to crack human skulls, crack bones, do different things, bust a head open, and this isn't just with zombies where they have rotten flesh, he can do this to humans, putting him within that regard, again, high regard, wall level, consistent stand of scale, and different regard things as well. So, That is consistent, that is laid out through all of these different clips, and is showcased multiple times. Or his case of gear slash versatileness and what we were granting him. Okay, we won't be giving him his bug, we won't be giving him his whip. He will have a machete, pipe, sledgehammer, and he'll have an assault rifle, like worst case of Jason Brody having his AK. Okay. And with his other stuff, he has the grappling hook, he can have a shield, he has his UV flashlight, won't work on Jason Brody, might blind him, but wouldn't even do that much. He has his other great flashlight, different capabilities that come into play, and he showcased again multi times a great deal of skill with these different regard of weapons, so that's kind of his equality. What is being said, he again is a good fighter, knowing, I would say, a good stance into martial arts. You know, he has his drive kick at different occasions, different stuff. So in a hand-to-hand, pit-for-pit, ball-for-ball, considerably Jason Brody might be out of his luck. But these people, depending on the occasion for how they might go about things, it might be a mixed regard fight all around. But I do think, you know, obviously because I made this video, that it's going to be very interesting, considerably equal regard of a fight in comparison when it comes down to the pit for pit all around run of stuff. You see ninja stars throwing knives, things like that. The general mish of things with this being said, but that is it when it comes down to base regard of Crane in this instance. Time to go ahead and get on to the actual regard fight and tell with Jason Brody. Jason Brody, I've already explained multiple times over in different occasions, so I'm just going to be going over what is already known. It's something about a dude. From being an American tourist turned warrior by the case of instance of channeling of all the rage and insanity pursuit within the case to save his friends and get vengeance for his brother Graham to being shot in the neck by Vaz Montenegro and being controlled and corrupted by Citra, the bad year herself, he... Jason Brody would come into a warrior beyond comprehension. Getting the tatao by Dennis himself, he would become the great killer that we know him to be. He'd become a beast in human skin. Jason Brody, multiple times over, has done a lot of crazy feats in the case of his arsenal and capabilities, having well over general regard scale, killing different people, surviving different little regard other than explosions, channeling the beast in every form of matter. Matt is a killer beyond comprehension, marking motherfuckers left and right. He's a killer without a doubt, ain't no cap on that stance in the statement. And simple the most is simply the fact that Jason, with all his persistent regard of killing and baseline case innocence of superhuman regard stuff, stats pretty well. And so with this being said, Jason comes down to speed. You could argue to be supersonic, even though there's not a consistent and strong form skills, but since he gets multiple times tagged by bullets as well. With this being said, then, most of all, your skill and the capability to be very adamant in speed and pop off in specific to people who you wouldn't expect to be able to be killed in the fast way, Jason does multiple times. And again, ran for militia, ran for the case of Hoyt's people, ran for Vaz's pirates, killed Hoyt. And even though, again, he did not kill Vaz, it's not out of pocket to say that he could. When it comes down to the case of his arsenal, like I said, we're giving him AK, we're giving him his machete, we're going to give him a rocket launcher, his grenades, his case of throwing knives. He will have all tattoos, as being said, no syringes, and all around just his general base regard stuff, pretty much be it. And this battle is going to be taking place in Haran, but in the following regard place. So it's not going to be that much ground for multi-case parkour, but I'm going to be having it on the side where there is going to be a little bit of some area to maybe be able to move. What is being said, mainly in the kind of like forest terrain regard sense, but it's gonna be a lot in the outskirts, so there's a lot of infinite potential for things to happen, but they'll have even ground to be able to move and do different things. What is being said, so it kind of is a dependent regard thing, but again, they'll have the capability to move. Crane will be able to parkour, Jason will be able to climb, do this. He'll have ways to get around. There will be different form things. And to mix up on it, so again, it's not just a simple whoever gets the right shot shoots the other, because both of them within an instant could kill each other just with their guns. What is being said, and I think, you know, it's an argument because of how much Jason uses guns more, that Jason is a better shot than Crane. I don't think most people would argue with that, hypothetically, right? But there might be an argument the way Crane used, because he's from a newer game. You know, he has a more advanced way of doing things, that he's going to be built like that, for instance. But, yeah, his movement and his precision is going to be mixed because of the zombies that are there. And I'm talking all types. It's not going to be like at night, but like there's going to be zombies that's going to mix them up. So I'm going to have a good equal regard situation, but it's going to be a mixed thing. But that's pretty much it for Jason Brody. Time to go and talk about the fight itself. Now, how this fight will go down all around will be a mixed bar with the zombies and everything, how they would contest each other in comparison, paw for paw, ball for ball. I think that all around Jason Brody will be able to mix up on him within the midst of the zombies. Crane knows this area more than him, so Jason obviously would just be killing the zombies in swift motion, shooting them down, or trying to get a shot on Crane here and there, and it might either clip him or miss in between. And Crane eventually, if it would have to come down to in the midst of just a pit for pit run around with things, will get to him. And sometimes, depending on it, with his wingsuit, he might be able to move around and get out of dodge. And either parachute down at a different point, and Crane would be trying to shoot him as well. And I don't think within this entire scenario, the bullets would be hurt either one of them, but it might really depend. Crane will be trying to move around and get in the midst of all sanctions of openings on this man Brody as good as possible, with this being said, and how he's faced other people and kind of had these more pit-for-pit things, fighting people like Tahir and different regard of fighting skill from Crane, and again his low smoke build and level regard thing. If Jason gets a clean hit with the rocket launcher, which I think is a 50-50, as I feel like Crane has a speed and all the zombies around, Crane might get hit a little bit with the damage, but not full point blank. But if he did, it obviously would be death for Crane. But then Crane, with his great regard type potency and his durability in a pit for pit, ball for ball fight, I think all around would be giving Jason Brody the lick. I think he would be giving him a big challenge after taking a lot of hits from people that are way more stronger than him, having a lot more considerable, I feel like, experience in some of the combat sense, but not necessarily in the overall battle sense. I think it can go either way. I think all around the fight is kind of 50-50 after breaking down the scaling, taking, considering all the things that make it very mixed, with this being said. But all around, I would say that I would give it most of the time to Crane, because when Crane knows the area a little bit more, he has a better scientific feel, he can use the zombies to distract Jason, he has a capability of the smarts and efficiency to get around, he's faced people more in a battle-hardened sense, he's a greater regard fighter and pit for pit, he has a case of the weapons to pull something in comparison, I feel like his bombs or other things will be able to mix up in the midst of the fight. And I feel like Oran will show efficiency when it comes down to the fight in comparison. And all around, I feel like he'll do good in comparison, and he'll be able to outdo him most of the time in the fight, and it won't be that much of an argument to say that Crane, all around with his efficiency and his just baseline unbreakable spirit, he'll go ahead and just outdo him in a consistent point for point, you know what I'm saying? Because like there's not that much, I feel like, to say for Jason in this type of environment to do more, even with him having his great durability and being damn near bullet resistant. Crane, excuse me, has been able to pull that, and we allow him to have a medikit, which, you know, for the sake of the, again, 50-50 comparable argument, he won't. I'm sorry, I had something stuck in my throat. Pause, chill out. He would be banging out with him and wouldn't really get put down the grand scope, in my opinion. I feel like he'll be able to move around, dodge and weave on the man like he's doing here, and be able to move and get around and take him to the edge. And even if you say that Crane doesn't win, I definitely think Jason and even Crane aren't leaving unscathed, and I feel like he just has capability to get around him in the grand scope, right? So I don't really think it's a really out of pocket statement for me, thinking about it in the case of my conclusion, again with the feats, the scans, stuff that y'all know, that make him a lot more durable, especially since from what has been shown, Jason doesn't have high regard, wall level regard stuff, and is dealing with that, and some of the stuff that he has, I don't know how much it will do. I definitely think it could injure him if he takes too much, but I think Crane, with his own stuff, will be able to output more even with taking case of less. You know what I'm saying? I feel like he'll be able to have the arsenal and the efficiency to pull the stuff that Jason can't. That's all around my opinion. So, in conclusion, I believe Crane wins high to extreme diff to a sense of, like, a very paw for paw, ball for ball. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just kind of how I feel like it is. Either way, though, I hope you guys have enjoyed. I'm going to see you guys in the next one. Peace out, Marmy. Love y'all.